You can fight anything, but you can't fight technology because it's going to change. And when it changes, it's going to change the form in which, well, I hate to use the word art again, but all right, well, the art is done. And a very good example is what happened to newspapers in the middle of the 19th century. Before the technology existed to reproduce photographs on newspapers, on newsprint, images in newspapers were done by people called wood engravers. Artists, or whatever you want to call them, would go off to an event like the American Civil War and make drawings of things happening, of people surrendering, of people shooting, people, whatever, of battles. And they would be sent, Winslow Homer did a lot of it, and they would be sent back to the newspapers in Boston or New York or wherever, and they would be given to wood engravers who would quite literally engrave on blocks of wood, not copy so much as more or less copy what they had seen. And those blocks of wood would be printed on each sheet of newspaper. And in the world of wood engravers, there must have been good and bad wood engravers, and probably even star wood engravers who made the most money and worked for the biggest and best newspaper. And this was, if not an art form, at least a craft, which was going fine until the invention of, I forget what it's called, photo offset printing or whatever it is, that allows photographs to be printed. And then they were gone. Whether they were good or bad, whether they had years of experience and they were creative artists, they were gone. And I suggest that my generation of cinematographers are, in a way, the last generation of wood engravers, and that the technology of imagery, of visual imagery and storytelling is already in the process of changing so rapidly, partly because of the technology of cameras and of imaging, and partly because of the technology of distribution, that within another 20 years, it's going to be radically, radically different. And that is not necessarily good or bad. It's just a fact of life. And I think that what is useful or important is to seize on it and make it good, and make video cameras or whatever kind of camera is going to come in the future assume its own properties. And they always talk now in shooting with video of, it doesn't look enough like film, we can make it look like film. Well, it's nonsense. It shouldn't look like a film, it should look like video. But you have to find out what the really basic properties of video are. Now, admittedly, the video keeps changing and as the technology goes rapidly, more and more and more and more, whatever. So who can keep up with it? And I don't know anything about it. I've never shot anything, I mean, I've shot, you know, home videos, but I've never shot a feature or anything else on video, only because no one has asked me. I'd love to do it, because I'd love to try and find out what it's really like. And some guys that I know have, and that what they say is fascinating when you hear them talk about it. And I've been on the set, an old guy used to be my operator now, shoots a TV series, several TV series, that he shot on video, and he became a kind of the big guru of it. And I used to visit his set, and it was fascinating to see. And it is not the same as film, and it shouldn't be thought of as the same as film. It has different properties, just as, you know, impressionism is different from the Italian Renaissance. Not better or worse, but simply different, and having its own properties. And those things are the things that people should be trying to figure out.